Hello, and thank you for joining the demo on efficient criticality assessment. My name is Mark Sinizich. I'm the product manager for APM Strategy. Today, we'll be looking at how to efficiently assess the criticality of your assets in order to establish risk-based maintenance and monitoring programs. One of the first key steps is to identify which assets and systems are most critical to your business. The benefit of doing so, obviously, is to help prioritize and identify the areas of risk where your organization is most vulnerable to either financial or other risk if the asset fails. And the importance of this is being able to use this data further down in stream in strategy development process to make sure that the strategies you have in place for your critical and non-critical pieces of equipment match the business objectives that you have and the maintenance dollars and monitoring dollars that you have to spend. So we're going to hop into the demo and take a deeper look at what this looks like. I'm in the asset criticality analysis module, and I'm going to open up a specific analysis that contains multiple pieces of equipment. In this example, we can see the current distribution of the assets that have been assessed across the top. These break down into any categorization that a customer deems as preferable. In this particular database, that's very high, high, medium, and low. As you can see, we also have some assets that have not been defined. And through the process of doing these assessments, you can assess assets one at a time, certainly cases where that is viable. But in other cases, you may want to assess pieces of equipment in bulk. And I could do assessments against multiple pieces of equipment. So what I'm going to do is highlight several pieces of equipment that are similar in nature. And then we're going to select those pieces of equipment for assessment. And in this example, I'll just select the first four. Once I've selected these individual assets, there's a bulk assessment button toward the top. I'm going to select bulk assessment. In this case, I'm using a risk matrix to do the assessment and from a safety, environment, operations, and financial perspective in each one of the categories. So for this asset, I'm going to go through and make my selections. And as we do this, the selections are saved, and then I can put my basis for why these assets are critical. And there may be a lot of justification for what we're putting in here, and depending on the process that you have in place, how much data you want to capture. So once we save that, you can see that the calculation is going to be applied to all the like pieces of equipment. And if we go back and take a quick look at those pumps that I was just assessing, I had previously selected the first four in my list. They all have been assessed with the value and the criticality category that was assessed a single time. And so the efficiency here is really nice. Another piece that makes the user more efficient would be the ability to apply an existing assessment to like assets. So if I've already assessed a piece of equipment and I want to apply that assessment to other pieces of equipment in the analysis, I can select the analysis that I want to apply. I can select the apply assessment button. And then I can find the assets, in this case, other pumps that are similar, and apply that assessment to these other pumps. And in this example, I'm simply hitting apply. And now if we go look at our subset of pumps again, we can see that we've quickly assessed these six individual pumps, four of them that I did in bulk. And then I leveraged one of those assessments to essentially assess the other two assets. And then finally, we've seen an example of where I'm assessing using a risk matrix. We can also use a similar approach, but a different assessment mechanism. And in this case, we would be using what we would consider a checklist and a policy. So now you can see when I go to assess a piece of equipment, I'm presented with a checklist that is configured by the customer to contain either questions or information that needs to be filled in by the user. And that information is essentially calculated through a policy associated with the criticality assessment family. And I can do that as well in bulk. So if we see here, I've got selected three assets and I'm going to go in and do a new assessment. And in this example, I'm just going to pick a high, medium, low. Now the policy is set up to actually take the maximum from each three of the consequence categories and assign that as the criticality to the asset. In this case, three assets. So I'm going to save that. The policy is executed and the assessments are completed in bulk here using a checklist and calculation through a policy approach. Thanks for watching, and I hope this demo was useful in showing you the efficiencies and the value of doing criticality assessment.